Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning class.
Morning sir.
Morning. Morning sir.
How are you today?
Alhamdulillah.
Fine sir.
Okay, very good. Are you tired now? It's long sessions, yeah, because you started from 8 and now it's almost 10:30. All right, so before we start, let's begin our lesson by reciting Al-Basmalah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, so today's topic is present perfect tense. Well, actually, we will be talking about perfect tenses, but today it will be more specific, yeah, present perfect tense. Yeah, do you still remember what was the topic yesterday? Do you still remember what was our topic last week?
Giving advice and comment.
Yeah, giving advice and suggestion. Correct, right. So I hope you check your Schoology and then start working on it, right? All right, so how many students are joining the class today? Only 36 students. Where are the rest? There are about 100 students, so it's around 50 or 64 students are missing. Before, how many students were joining? How many students joined before? Now someone is missing again, 35 students now. So where are those students who are missing now? All right, so hopefully next meeting, yeah, will be more students will join the class. Not only English, but all subjects. Okay, so before we start, I'd like to introduce you to the learning objective. First, you will be able to identify the social function and structure of present perfect tense. Yeah, the structure of perfect tense. And number two, you will be able to analyze a sentence using present perfect tense. And number three, you will be able to differentiate the use of perfect tenses. There are various perfect tense. So it's not only one perfect tense, but present perfect tense and past perfect tense, future perfect tense. So among those tenses, the learning objective of this lesson is you will be able to differentiate the use of those perfect tenses. And the last but not the least, you will be able to construct a sentence using present perfect tense in a proper ways of proper a correct sentence. So those are the learning objective. So let's start. Okay, so before we start, I'd like to introduce you again. The present perfect tenses, there are many uses of it, right? You can use to express about finished action, past event and present result here, and then recent completed actions, and then unfinished actions, duration from past until now, life experiences, accomplishment, things over time, and multiple action at different times. So these are the different uses of perfect tense, but I don't think we will finish in one meeting for those all usages. At least one or two of them we can do it today, right? So the rest we will continue the next meeting. So okay, so just for your introduction, yeah, these are the uses of present perfect tense. Okay, I have a question. What is in your mind? What do you know about present perfect tense? Right, I am inviting all students to come in and join and share ideas. Yes, please volunteer. What is in your mind when we're talking about present perfect tense?
Kejadian yang sudah dilakukan, sir.
Kejadian yang sudah dilakukan. Is that all? So what is the difference between present perfect tense and past tense then? Past tense, kejadian yang sudah dilakukan. But what, when you say present perfect tense, is kejadian yang sudah dilakukan. So what is the difference? Are they same?
Kalau present perfect tense itu, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Go ahead.
Maksudnya baru selesai, sir. Baru saja dilakukan.
Alright, okay. Baru saja dilakukan. Yeah. Talking about something in past, yeah. Present perfect tense is more specific. Nah, kalau kalian lihat ini, ya. Lihat ini the uses ya, di sinilah mungkin kalian akan mengetahui these uses will tell you more about how to use present perfect tense. Ya, seperti ini ya, finish actions, past event and present result. Ya, if you have to understand, if you translate into bahasa Indonesia, kejadian yang sudah selesai, finished action. Karena kejadiannya sudah selesai. Ya, started in the past, the event started in the past, but the result is in the present. Tapi hasilnya itu atau efeknya itu sekarang. If we example like she has lost her wallet, she cannot find it. Because he lost her wallet, she cannot find it. She has lost her wallet, she cannot find it. Efeknya apa? Kapan kejadiannya? When did it happen? In the past. Yeah, it happened in the past. Yeah, but the effect, when is the effect?
Present.
Yeah, in the present. What is the effect? Apa efeknya? Dia nggak bisa menemukannya, ya karena hilang tadi. Yeah, that is the example. Okay. So we will be talking one by one of the uses. First, talking about the first usage, yeah. But definition of, let's talk about the present perfect tense. What is present perfect tense? Yeah, like your friend, one of your friends said before. So present perfect tense is used to express an event that started in the past, and the impact of the event is now continuing. Yeah, jadi efeknya itu terasa sekarang. Ya, kejadiannya started in the past, ya. The event is started in the past, but the impact of the event is now. Ya, is now. So this is used to express action completed recent past. Ya, seperti tadi dibilang, ya kejadian yang baru-baru saja selesai. Kalau kejadian yang baru-baru saja selesai, efeknya pasti masih terasa, ya kan? Another example is I have eaten my dinner or I have eaten my lunch. When I say I have eaten my lunch, itu sudah terjadi belum? Happened it already or not?
Yes, sir.
Sudah
ya. So can kapan kejadiannya? When it happened? When did it happen?
In the past.
In the past, yeah. In the past, maybe recently, ya baru-baru saja mungkin ya. Because it's time for lunch time, for example now. Jadi kan berarti kan kejadiannya baru saja. Karena sekarang ini waktunya makan. But I said I have eaten my lunch. So that is the action. And what is the effect or the impact? Kalau kalian sudah makan siang, what is the effect?
Fully.
Yeah, correct. I am full. I am full. That is the effect. The effect you feel now. But the action started in the past or happened in the past. So that is present perfect tense. When we talking about past tense, I ate my dinner last night. Nah, kalau saya bilang misalkan I ate my dinner last night. Masih ada impact-nya enggak? Do you feel the impact now?
Udah enggak, sir.
Hah?
Enggak ada, sir.
Udah enggak? Kenapa, enggak? Kenapa enggak terasa lagi? Karena udah lapar lagi, ya kan? So you feel hungry now. Because last night, it's the duration is so long already. There is no impact. But kalau misalkan you had your dinner at 6 and then you talk about that after at 7, at 1 hour after dinner. Nah, that's still okay, ya masih. Nah, pas sekarang, last night and now the gap is still is very long. So you don't feel the effect now. So it means that that sample or that action is past tense, not present perfect tense. Can you find the difference now? Bisa dipahami itu perbedaannya?
Bisa, sir.
Yeah, okay. So that is present perfect tense. Okay. For example, like this one. I have lost my key. So now I feel, oh, where is my key? I'm searching my key, you know. Where is my key? My key was on the table before. But now I didn't find it. I don't find my key. Jadi apa yang terjadi? What happened? I have lost my key. So do you think it's present perfect tense or past tense?
Present, sir.
Present perfect or past tense?
Present perfect, sir.
Present perfect tense. Kenapa dia menjadi present perfect tense?
Karena efeknya masih ada.
Ya, dia masih mencari-cari sekarang loh. Kalau dia kemarin pasti dia nggak mencari-cari lagi sekarang. Dia nggak kaget lagi sekarang gitu. She will not be shocked anymore. Now she's shocked. Oh, where is my key? I have lost my key. Ya. Atau misalkan sini she want to leave from work, ya. Jadi ketika dia mau pulang misalkan ini. Dia terus mau ngambil motornya atau keretanya. Ketika mau ngambil kuncinya, ngecek di sakunya, so dia enggak menemukan kuncinya. So dia bilang I lost my key atau dia bilang I have lost my key.
I have lost my key.
Yeah. Efeknya apa di situ? What is the effect? What is the impact? Ketahuan ada impactnya nggak kalau dia bilang I have lost my key? Impactnya apa dong? What is the impact? Dia nggak bisa pulang. Dia harus mencari-cari lagi, ya kan? Kalau hilangnya itu kemarin, mungkin dia nggak mencari-cari lagi. Mungkin sudah ke tukang kunci dia, ya. Atau mungkin sudah ketemu lagi. So that is present perfect tense. Bisa dipahami? Can you understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good. Right, so Maria has lost her key. So Maria cannot find her key and she has lost her key. So she has lost her key. She lost it and she does not have it now. Ya. Jadi dia enggak kuncinya enggak sama dia sekarang. Kenapa? Karena udah hilang. Ya. Oke. Okay. So, or can you give me another example from yourself? Ada yang mau ngasih example? Can you give me another example? Okay, I am inviting students to give me another example. Yes, please.
Hi, sir.
Siapa itu? Can you tell me your name? Because I cannot see your name here.
My name is Fajar Akbar, sir.
Fajar Akbar. Okay, yeah, please, Fajar.
I have lost my money.
I have lost my money. Yeah. Efeknya apa? Kapan itu hilangnya?
Semalam, sir. Belum ketemu sampai sekarang.
Oh, belum semalam dan belum ketemu sampai sekarang. Okay, no problem. Next, ada lagi nggak? So who wants to give me another example? Ada lagi? Selain jangan menggunakan kata lost lagi. Jangan menggunakan don't use another. You have to use another word. Ya, yeah, jangan gunakan lost lagi. Biar berkembang vocabularies-nya. Yes, please. Other students.
Me, sir.
Yes, please. Who's that? Please tell me your name.
Pak Kavi, Rishna Pradipta.
Okay, Pak Kavi, yes. Yes, please, Pak Kavi.
I've learned to ride my bike.
I've
learned to ride my bike.
Say again.
I've learned to ride my bike.
Oh, I have learned to ride my bike. Yeah. When?
Yes, sir. When I was young.
Oh, when I was young. Berarti udah lama itu ya?
Yes, sir. But the effect kan, I can ride my bike.
Oh, the effect now, yeah. Long time ago, efeknya sekarang gitu. Okay.
Yes, sir.
I have ya. Misalkan ada, kamu kok bisa ini ya? Kamu kok bisa naik sepeda ya? Atau kamu kok bisa naik apa namanya itu mengemudikan helikopter? Yes, I have learned. Ya, yeah. Bolehlah. Okay. Ada lagi? One more maybe? Maybe sesuatu yang terjadi baru-baru ini, tapi efeknya masih terasa sekarang.
Me, sir.
Yes. Who's that?
Uni, sir.
Uni, okay.
I have breakfast.
I have?
Eaten breakfast.
I have eaten breakfast. Efeknya apa? What is the impact?
I'm full until now.
I am full now. Yeah, I have eaten my breakfast, or you can say I have had my breakfast. Yeah, jadi boleh menggunakan kata have. Jadi I have had my breakfast, or you can say I have eaten my breakfast. Yeah, boleh pakai eaten, pakai have. I have my breakfast. Okay. All right. Very good. Next. Okay. Look at the picture. Who can describe the picture? Picture number one. Use a present perfect tense. Coba. What will you say? Ah.
Me, sir.
Yeah, who's that?
Dita, sir.
Dita, okay. Dita Ramadhani, ya. Yes, please, yes, Dita. Picture number one or picture number two?
Number one, sir.
Number one, okay. Please go ahead.
I have hurt my finger.
I have hurt my finger. Yeah, finger, yeah, finger. Or you can say I have cut my fingers. Ya. Yeah. Jadi kalau misalkan kita lagi ngiris bawang, misalkan when you slice onions and then tangannya kepotong. So how do you say that in English? Gimana kita bilangnya di bahasa Inggris? I have cut my fingers. Ya. Yeah. Saya sudah memotong tangan saya. Ya, yeah, bukan dengan sengaja memotong, tetapi dengan tidak sengaja. Ya, yeah. Jadi kalau bahasa Inggris I have cut my fingers, yeah. I have cut my fingers. Good. So, what is the effect? Efeknya apa? Jari saya berdarah, ya. Yeah. So, my finger is bleeding. Itu kelihatan itu darahnya, ya. Yeah, meskipun sedikit. I have cut. Ow! I have. Misalkan lagi ngiris bawang, ya. Yeah. You cut the slice. Oh, you slice the onions. Ya. Yeah. And then, ow! Oh, what happened? So, ibumu, your mother is asking, what's wrong? I have cut my fingers. Ya, meskipun baru saja dilakukan, dan the effect is still, you still feel that your fingers is very painful, and then your finger is bleeding. Ya, masih sakitnya masih terasa, dan darahnya masih mengalir. So, when your mother asks, what's wrong? What is going on? What happened? Yeah. Oh, I have cut my fingers. Bukan I cut my fingers. Not I am cutting my fingers. Like I'm cutting my fingers, lagi sedang motong. But that's in this situation, you gotta say, I have cut my fingers. Saya sudah memotong jari saya. Bukan dengan sengaja, tapi saya sudah melukai my fingers, jari saya. You got it? Understand? Right,
yes,
picture
sir.
Number two.
Yes,
picture
sir.
Number two.
Me, sir.
Who's that?
Nadia, sir.
Nadia, yes, please, Nadia.
He has made a mistake.
He had made a mistake. Yeah. He had made a mistake. Kesalahannya was crime. He have done a crime, maybe, ya. Yeah. Kalau misalkan situasinya, polisi ngapain itu, ya? Polisi menangkap pencuri itu. Polisi sudah menangkap pencuri itu. How would you say that in English?
They catch the crime.
No.
Menangkap. What do you say in English? Menangkap.
Catch.
Catch. Menangkap. Selain catch.
Call.
Menangkap buronan, menangkap pencuri. Oh. Biasanya apa kita pakai?
Take, sir.
Capture.
Apa?
Take.
Ah, oke. Okay. Kita pakai arrest. Apa? Arrest. Ya, yeah. Arrest. Ya, yeah. You are arrested. Kamu ditangkap. Kalau polisi ngomongnya biasanya begini. Ah, kamu ditangkap. You caught. Nah, enggak. Biasanya polisi enggak bilang you are caught, ya. Yeah. Tapi you are under arrest. Biasanya itu oh you are arrest. Ya, yeah, kamu ditangkap, ya. Yeah. You are under arrest. So, pakai tangkap, menangkap, polisi menangkap buronan atau pencuri. Yeah. The police have arrested the man in connection with the robbery. Right, so from these two sentences, do you think it is perfect tense or not? From these two sentences, do you think it's perfect tense or not? Present perfect tense or not?
Yes, sir.
Ah, how do you know it's a present perfect tense? How do you know these two sentences? Present perfect tense.
The ebook is now, sir.
Kenapa? Gimana? Kalau dari construction-nya, kalau dari structure-nya, can you tell you that the sentences are present perfect tense? Bisa nggak kalian mengetahui kalau dua sentences ini adalah present perfect tense? Dari mana kalian mengetahuinya? How can you tell?
Menggunakan have dan verb three, sir.
Okay, very good. That is correct. Yeah. So we need we use have here, and then for the verb we use verb two or three.
Three, sir.
Verb three. Okay. Can you, so why is it different and this one is different? This one is police have and this one is I have. I've. Is that okay?
Okay.
Okay. This one is shortened, ya, dipendekkan, ya, contraction, ya, dipendekkan atau disingkat. So I have, you can construct it, become I've. Yeah, I've. So police have arrested. Right, so I cut my finger, I have cut my finger, so my finger is bleeding. My finger is bleeding, I have cut my finger, I have cut my finger. So I've cut my finger and I have cut my fingers. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now, okay, the two pictures. Okay, so can you tell the pictures, I mean, can you describe the pictures using present perfect tense? Picture number one.
She have got married, sir.
Okay, they have got married. Yeah, correct. Yeah, they have gotten married. Okay, they have got married or they have got married or they have gotten married?
Gotten married, sir.
Yeah, you both okay, actually. Yeah, you can say they have gotten married or they have got married. Yeah, both okay. Tapi dia kalau Amerika, dia menggunakan I have gotten married. Kalau di Inggris, British-nya, dia boleh I have got married or I have gotten married. Ya, boleh dua-duanya. Okay? Alright, so the next picture. How would you describe this picture? Picture number two. Ada pesawat dan dia bawa ini.
They have gone a holiday, sir.
They have gone holiday. Kalau mungkin lebih spesifik, boleh-boleh saja, tapi mungkin lebih spesifik kalau lihat dari pesawat dan ada travelernya itu.
They have landed, sir.
Ah, okay. They have landed or the plane has landed, yeah. They have just got married and then the plane has landed. Yeah. Is that present perfect tense?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. All right. So how about this one? Now, this one I can say they have just had an accident. And this one, another picture. Kalau satu lagi, they have graduated. Ya, dan mereka udah lulus ya. Okay. Alright, now, how to form present perfect tense? Gimana sih caranya kita membentuk present perfect tense? Ya. So, Mary, for example, like Mary has submitted her homework. Mary has submitted her homework. Is it present perfect tense or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Mary, what do you call this, Mary?
Subject, sir.
A subject. And then has, we need has or have. Yeah. Yeah, we need have or has. Yeah, kata kerja bantu ya. And then after has or have, apa itu?
Verb three
itu yang mana sih? Kalau misalkan ada speak.
Spoken, sir.
Speak, what is the verb three of speak?
Spoken, sir.
Spoken, speak, spoke, spoken. Correct. How about give?
Given, sir.
What is the third verb of give?
Given, sir.
Given, sir.
Given, yeah, that's correct. And how about the word understand?
Understood, sir.
Understood, okay. How about drive?
Driven, sir.
Driven, okay, very good. Okay, this one, it's a bit difficult. Okay, this one is more difficult. I hope you can, but I hope you still can answer that. What is the verb three of run?
Run, sir.
Run. Okay, that's correct. Yeah, run. Very good. Yeah, okay, and then her homework is objects. Very easy, right? This is how we form the present perfect tense. There is a subject, have or has, depend on subject. Yeah. Why do we use has here, not have?
Because the subject is she.
Because the subject is singular, yeah. Third person, singular, yeah. How about if I change here, they?
They have
submitted her homework. Okay, very good. Yeah. Next, this is what we call, this is what we call positive sentence or affirmative sentence. Kalimat positive. How about a negative sentence? Can you change this sentence to be negative?
Mary
hasn't submitted her homework. Okay, it's very easy. Yeah, you just add not here. Mary has not submitted her homework. Okay. Right. So the next. This is only a negative sentence. And then how about this is what we call. Okay, can you change it to be interrogative sentence?
Has Mary
Yeah. Can you repeat once again?
Has Mary submitted her homework?
All right. Do you still use verb 3 or verb 1?
Verb 3, sir.
Still using verb 3. Okay, we're still using verb 3. Has Mary submitted her homework? Okay, correct. Subject. Sorry, this is wrong. Yeah, this is not subject. The subject is here. This is what we call. This is. We have to switch ya. Ini sininya kurang pas ya. Have-nya ini harusnya di depan ya. Sorry. This is what we call interrogative sentence. Has is have or has, and then. Mary is a subject, and then submitted is a verb 3, and then her homework is an object. Yeah, okay. Okay, so I think we spend more than 30 minutes already. It's almost 11 o'clock. Well, actually, we still have a lot to talk about, yeah? The uses of present perfect tense. But I think we're going to talk about that in the next meeting, yeah, next week, yeah? Okay, for now, I think. Okay, do you have question before we close the presentation? Any question?
Sir.
Yeah. Please.
Tadi kan di gambar yang ada polisinya, sir. Itu sir, kayak police has.
Which one? Ah, ini ya. Oh, sorry.
Yes, sir.
Ini ya. Yes, sir. Police have arrested the man in connection with the robbery. Ya, it can be has, it can be have ya. Karena ini ada dua polisi ya. Policeman harusnya di sini ya. Policeman ada dua policeman ya. Ya bisa kalau pakai has juga boleh ya, berarti satu polisi ya. Kalau dua polisi police have ya, policeman ya, ditambahkan man di sini ya. Police have arrested ya. Okay, thank you very much. Ya, tapi ada dua polisi, bisa policeman or police have arrested. Ya, berarti enggak di situ ada berapa polisi, kita enggak tahu ya. Enggak ada dua di sini, berarti ada, kalau ada dua berarti have ya. Tapi kalau satu,
okay,
yes ya. Okay. Police has arrested ya, tapi kalau misalkan enggak ditentukan, police has arrested the man in connection with the robbery. Ya. Policeman ya, policeman ya. Okay, thank you. Any other question? Ada lagi pertanyaan? Yes. No more question? Ya, kita lanjutkan minggu depan dengan topik masih present perfect tense ya, because we haven't finished this. So next meeting we will be talking more about the use of present perfect tense. So the use of present perfect tense ini dan ini juga there are many ya. And we'll be talking about that next meeting. That's all for today. Thank you very much for joining the class today. And have a nice day. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih.
Thank you, sir.